Toronto commitment within his own game. And we talked about it last night. He does his thing his way, and he's done it 54 times this year.
So here we go, 3-on-3 hockey. The Ducks have it first with Cam Fowler. Gives it to Lundestrom. Lundestrom carries out. Ducks this year, 4-6 in games decided in overtime. Minnesota, including last night's win, 6-4. Raquel works to the middle. Has Kaprizov riding him. Raquel still with it. Hands it back to Fowler, and he'll retreat through neutral ice, allowing the Ducks to change. Minnesota will do the same. At least two of their players. It's now Johansson and Spurgeon. Kaprizov still on the ice. Zegras to Drysdale. His shot blocked. Scooped up by Johansson. He leads the charge the other way. Johansson plays it across to Kaprizov. Kaprizov will leave it for Brodin. Now he heads to the bench. Brodin to Fiala, just over the boards. Fiala drives in. Didn't get much on it. Got it back. Feeds Brodin. Brodin to Johansson. Johansson circling wide. Crisscrosses with Fiala. Now in the skates of Fiala. Zegras disrupts. Brodin backpedals away, and Comtois has it. He has Zegras with him into the Minnesota zone. Back to the trailing Drysdale, and a kick save by Talbot. Drysdale able to get to the puck before Johansson. Really showing his skating ability here, 3-on-3.
Yeah, a lot, a little loose there. Kevin Fiala a couple of times in the offensive zone had Zegras caught flat-footed, but then it's the Ducks that get the 2-on-1 and then actually hit the second wave.
Terry. Terry's wide, sharp angle shot. Easily knocked down by Talbot. Dumba to Zuccarello. He drags it past Terry. Goes across for Rask. Rask spins along the wall. Feeds Dumba. Back to Rask. Dumba to Zuccarello. Zuccarello protects the puck along the boards. Pressured by Terry. They both go down. And Dumba will easily get to this puck before Terry. Long lead pass, finds Rask. Rask in, fire, scores! He had a chance to seal it into the empty net. He just wanted the drama of the overtime winner. And Minnesota will finish the season with the best home record in franchise history.
Well, they always say focus on your next shift. Doesn't matter the play you made the shift before, Victor Rask gives the Ducks one extra point. Ryan Miller goes out with an OTL instead of a loss, but good finish, good play. Stretch pass to the neutral zone. He comes in, a little look off. And he does have a sneaky little wrist shot. We've seen this earlier in the year. He can fool goaltenders, gets it off quick, beats Miller to that low blocker side. Wow. Improved to 21-5-2. At the XL Energy Center.
It's the best points percentage they've ever had in this building. Wild players, Ducks players, congratulating Ryan Miller as his career comes to an end tonight. His parents in attendance. And the winningest American-born goalie ever finishes up with an OTL here in St. Paul.
And Jared Spurgeon leads the line. Next behind him, Nick Bonino, former Duck. Teammates, Ryan Suter, Ryan Miller, Olympics. They're the parents of Ryan Miller.
Just amazing, some of the things we've been able to witness here in St. Paul this year. Miller playing his final game, Patrick Marleau becoming the all-time games played leader. It's been a special season, and it's always something when you see the respect that NHL players have for each other in the history of the game. Congratulations to Ryan Miller on one phenomenal career. The Wild capped their home season with a 4-3 overtime win. Wild Live is next.